Buzzer TV presents vintage game shows on Amazon.
Ace is high. Deuce is low. Call it right and win the dough on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you, man. I thank you, friends. Thank you for joining us on Card Sharks. Oh, yes. Love it. Thank you for coming down. Thank you for joining us at home. Card Sharks, it's a game of decisions. You can win a fortune on the turn of just one single card. I hope sometime you'll come down and join us. Right now, let's get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, start loading in the cards. Red cards on top to be played by the champion. The lower cards, the blue card, to be played by the challenger. And now let's meet today's Card Sharks. This is our champion, Royce Moss. Hello there, Royce. $9,325 so far.
That's right.
Not bad at all. $9,300. You said earlier that you work for a restaurant chain.
That's correct.
You manage the chain or what?
No, I'm a supervisor over five in a chain.
Five? That must
yes.
keep you very busy.
Mm-hmm.
Good. I'm glad you could take some time out and join us. You're doing very well.
Thank you.
And a lady who's doing very well, our challenger. Of course, we play the best two out of three. And right now, the challenger, Sue Ann, is leading 1-0. Sue Ann Murray. Hi, Sue Ann.
Hi.
You got $100 for the game. Sue Ann, you said that you were going to... That's all right. You want to applaud Sue Ann. Go right ahead. Yeah. You said you want to get into the State Department. Where would you like to, if you could pick a foreign country, where would you like to be transferred?
I think I'd like to be transferred to Germany because it's very beautiful over there.
How do you think that, you have an unusual voice. How do you think they'd take to your voice in Germany?
I don't know. It seems like it's sort of squished.
You must have sung bass in the choir or something, so I'm sure. Yes.
Must.
Good to have you back. Good luck to both
Thank
of you.
You.
And each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards. And the red cards on top to be played by Royce. The lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by Sue Ann. The cards have been shuffled and cut before going on the air. And the object of the game is to work your way across the board, predicting whether each of these cards is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Now, before you can begin calling high-low on the cards, you have to first answer a high-low toss-up question. Here comes my... I've been calling this R2-D2. There's enough R2-D. I'm going to change it now to... G2T2 for Goodson Todman, right?
Oh, good.
The fact that I'm saying G2T2 and saying it twice has no meaning whatsoever to you at home, but to me it means another 10 bucks in my pocket. So thank you, Mark. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. And of course, we base all our polls on 100 people. They test your ability to judge human nature. And Sue Ann, the first question will go to you.
Okay.
We polled 100 ex-convicts, gentlemen who have spent time in jail. And we asked those ex-convicts, do you think the judge gave you a fair sentence? And of course, we want to thank the ex-convicts for taking part in our poll, as we thank everyone who does. Do you think the judge gave you a fair sentence? What did the ex-convicts say? How many said yes?
How many said yes? I don't think very many of them would, because they always say it's a bum rap. I would say... I'd say 16 said yes.
Sue Ann says that 16 of the ex-convicts said that the judge gave them a fair sentence. Higher or lower, Royce?
I think it's a very good answer, but I would say a little lower than that. I don't
you
think
say even lower.
Not sentence.
All right. So if it is lower, Royce, you go to the board first, if not, Sue Ann does, and I'll find out as you do. The actual number of ex-convicts who said the judge gave them a fair sentence is... 59, not lower, it's higher, Sue Ann, yeah. They had a little more understanding than you thought. Sue Ann, we'll take a look at your base card. You answered the question, you have the right to change this base card. If you'd like, you have a 7. You want to play that or change it?
I change it, I don't...
Here's the next card off the top of your deck, and this one you must play. It is a 9. Not too much of a change. Sue Ann, is this card higher or lower than that?
Lower. Lower.
Lower than a 9. Remember, if it's another 9 you lose, it must be lower than a 9.
Lower.
It's a king. It is not lower. And not only do you lose that card, but that gives Royce a free play at his cards and a look at his base card. It's a king.
Yeah, yeah. Good.
You couldn't change it if you wanted to, but I don't think you want to. Call us.
Next card be lower.
Lower than a king. It is a 10. Now, Royce, remember, you can freeze here and protect yourself, or you can continue calling all the way across the board. But, of course,
I'll go on.
The cards if you're wrong.
I'll go on. Next card, I think, will be lower.
Lower
yes.
than a 10.
Mm-hmm.
It's a queen. Couldn't do it. You lose both of those cards. Janice, if you will, fill in the spaces. And Royce, we'll go to a question to you. We asked 100 men in California, have you ever made love to a woman the first time you went out with her? How many say yes?
Interesting question.
Now, Royce, up until now, you've had an extraneous comment on every question. Isn't it interesting? You haven't said anything about this one. How many said yes?
I better not either. I'd say...
100, says a man in the audience.
Repeat the question again.
Yes, indeed. We asked 100 men, have you ever made love to a woman the first time you went out with her? How many said yes?
I'd say 68.
68.
Yeah.
Sue Ann, higher or lower?
I'd say, out of the people I know, lower.
The actual number of men who said they made love to a woman the first time they went out with her is 53. It's lower. Sue Ann, you got it. Sue Ann, you want to keep this 9?
No, I'm going to get rid of it.
And you have a 4. That's a better change. Call this one, Suette.
I will say the next card is higher.
Higher than a 4. Royce wants a deuce. She wants
deuce.
Higher. It is a 6. It is higher.
Okay, I will play on and I will say the next card is higher.
Higher than a 6. It's a big ace.
I will play on and I will say the next card is lower.
Lower than an ace. It's a 3.
I will play on and I say the next card is higher.
You're risking them all, but if this is higher, we have a new champion. Sue Ann, higher than a 3. It's a jack! She got it with 4 cards! Yes, indeed! Sue Ann, congratulations! Fine win. Royce, you're leaving us well taken care of. $9,325. You're a fine champion.
Thank you.
Good luck with all you do in the future, Royce. Thank you. Sue Ann, come on down here with me. Congratulations. Take a rest for a moment. We'll be back with the money cards where Sue Ann can win over $28,000 right after this. Good win. And Sue Ann Murray, our new champion. Congratulations, Sue Ann.
Thank you.
Are you ready now to go after the big dollars?
Yep.
You've got $200 for winning the match, and now we're going to open the board and get to the money cards. Sue Ann, now the $200 you won in the match, that's yours to keep. Now we've got brand new cards all shuffled and cut, and we're going to give you new money to play with. This time you're going to bet that money. Starting on the bottom line, $200. Bet it as you will with these 3 cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money. Minimum bets are $50 until you get to that top card, that big bet. And there you must bet at least half the dollars. It can really add up. I hope you do very well.
Thank
you. You all relaxed and ready?
Yes.
Good luck. Let's get good cards. We'll start you with $200. And as always, a choice of 2 base cards. And the first base card is a 3. Yeah, that's
okay.
A good card. You're
going
to play. Sue Ann, $200 and a 3. What's your bet?
I'll bet all of it that the next card is higher.
Did you say all of it, Sue Ann?
All 200.
Now remember, it must, as in the game, it must be higher than a 3. $200 higher than a 3. It's a 9. $400 and a 9. What's your bet here?
I will bet $100 that the next card is lower.
$100 lower than a 9. It's a jack. But you had good intuition there because you only lost the $100. Pretty good card here, a jack. You have $300. What's your bet here?
I will bet $300 that the next card is lower.
Now, Suzanne, are you letting them talk you into something out there?
No. Oh.
$300 lower. It's on you now. Remember, yeah, you talked her into it. Lower than a jack. $300. Let's be there. Oh, it's a king. You lost the $300, but you're not out of it yet because you've got a good card, the king. And remember I said we move it up to the next level and add the $200. So it gives you another $200 to play with a good card, Sue Ann. What's your
bet? $200 that the next card is lower.
All right, if you're wrong now, it's all over, so we've got to build it up. Lower than a king for $200. It's another king! My goodness gracious! Sue Ann, those cards were not working for you. Come on down here. That was terrible the way they were falling.
I know.
You got to try to do it again, though.
Yep.
She'll try to do it again against a new challenger right after we take time out for this. You got $200. Yeah. Sue Ann, those cards were not falling right for you up there.
No, they weren't.
Second time in a row, the cards were kind of in the middle, but I must say, you bet them right. The king, the odds are in your favor with that king, that another one was not going to come up. Of course, we say all the time that the cards are shuffled and cut and dealt, and they seal them up. We don't know how they're going to come out. You still feel confident to do it again?
Yes.
All right, let's get the cards dealt out for the next match. Two new decks, and we'll meet our next player here on Card Sharks. Hello, Bill Blumen. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, sir.
Tell us a little about yourself.
Well, I'm originally from Nashville, Tennessee, and
I never would have guessed.
Oh, I don't know. And I've been out here a couple of years. I'm self-employed as an independent agent for a major bank, and play the guitar and sing like a wild crow and write some songs every once in a while.
How does a wild crow sing, Bill?
Very bad.
Very bad. Yeah. Good to have you here with us. Good luck in the match. Bill, of course, you'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Sue Ann will play the red cards on the top, and we'll start the match with a question to you, Sue Ann. We asked 100 housewives across the country, do your husband's shirts have ring around the collar? How many said yes?
A lot. It's very hard to get the collars clean. I would say 73 said yes.
73. She says it's 73 housewives said the husbands have ring around the collar. Bill, higher or lower?
Well, I think that too many people are influenced by TV commercials. I believe the answer is lower than that.
You say lower.
Yeah.
The audience kind of agrees with you. The actual number of housewives who admitted their husband's shirts have ring around the collar is 16. Very much lower, Bill.
Let's get to the board.
And Bill knows he's got that all-important control of the board to start with, and we'll look at your base card. It is a 10. You want to play that or change it, Bill?
I think I want to change that 10.
Here's the next card. You must play this one. It is a 5.
It's a little better.
Higher or lower, Bill?
Next card is higher.
Higher than a 5? It's
all
a
right. Ace. That's a good one. Mm-hmm. I better continue. And the next card has got to be lower than the ace.
Only an ace would lose. Lower than an ace.
Low.
It's an 8.
Good. Okay. I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze it right there.
All right.
All right, we can't take those cards away from you. You need just 2. You've kept Sue away from her cards, and the question goes to you, Bill.
All right.
We took a confidential poll of 100 married men in California and asked them, have you ever considered having an affair with another woman? How many men said, yes, they have considered having an affair?
I feel like it's probably crossed every man's mind at one time or another. I'd say about 73 men said that.
73. He says 73 men have considered having an affair with another woman, Sue Ann. Higher or lower?
Well, if they did, they shouldn't. I'll say lower.
You say lower.
Yeah.
The actual number of married men who said they had considered having an affair is 40. It is lower. Ooh, that's a surprise. Sue Ann, you have it. And we have a look at your base card. It is a 5. You want that card?
I will change it.
Try to improve on the 5. It is a king.
I will play it, and I will say the next card is lower.
Lower than a king. It's a queen.
I will play it, and I will say the next card is lower.
Lower than a queen again. It's an 8.
Oh.
Lost both of those cards. Big break for Bill. Bill, you must play off the 8. You cannot change it. Call this card.
Higher.
Higher than an 8. It's another 8, not higher. You lose it. Wow. Fill in the spaces, Janice. No one could improve on that. The question goes to you, Sue Ann.
Okay.
We polled 100 women senior citizens and asked them, would you like to be young again? How many said yes?
I will say 82 of them said they would like, 82 would like
82.
To be young again.
She says 82 women senior citizens would like to be young again. Bill, higher or lower?
I think that a lot of people would like to be young again, but I think that's too high. I say it's lower than that.
You say lower. Your judgment of intuition says lower. The actual number of women senior citizens who said they would like to be young again is 36.
All
very
right.
Much lower, Bill.
Gotta get rid of that.
I kind of like that. If you've enjoyed life, you should be happy with what you are at what time you are. Bill, you want to play this 8 or change it?
No, I want to change it.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck, and it's a king.
Good.
That's a good change.
Good card. I believe the next card is lower than the king.
Lower than a king. It's a good. Four, very much slower. You're going to go for it, you're going to freeze.
Yeah, I want to go, and I hope the next card's higher.
This is higher than a four. You have the first game in our best two out of three match. Higher than a four. It's another four. It is not higher. And Sue Ann, you got a chance to play off that king and call this card.
I will play the king, and I say the next card is lower.
Lower than a king. It is a three.
I will continue to play, and I say the next card is higher.
Higher than a three. It's a big ace.
I will continue to play, and I say the next card is lower.
Lower than an ace. It's a king and a king.
I will continue to play, and I say the next card is lower.
Going all the way, trying to turn over four cards for the win. Lower than a king. It's a two, and she did it. It's four straight cards. Win number one for the champion. Bill, those cards were tough for you. Maybe they'll be better in the next game. Janice will clear the board. We'll get to the next game right after we take time out for this. Please watch. Okay. Sue Ann with game number one and $100.
Mm-hmm.
Bill, you said you thought you had it with that one.
I thought I could beat that four.
That was a good card, that four, but it just bounced back to haunt you with another one. All right, Bill, you got to make a comeback now. You need this, and we'll start with a question to you. Bill, Janice, if you will, load in the cards. Same decks of cards, and here's the question. Bill, we pulled 100 women at The Price is Right and asked them, do you find men with hairy chests sexy? How many of those women said yes? All of them, says one lady out there.
My girlfriend likes my hairy chest, so I'm going to say that probably about 68 of them.
You say 68. If I had to depend on a hairy chest, I'd be in a lot of trouble. You say 68. Sue Ann, he says 68 women say they find the men with hairy chests sexy. Do you think it's higher or lower?
I disagree. I say it's lower.
You say lower. You don't like hairy chests, huh?
Nope.
The actual number of women who said hairy chests are sexy is 59. It is lower. Sue Ann. Here's the base card for you, Sue Ann. It is a queen. You can play
it. I will keep that card, and I say the next card is lower.
Lower than a queen. It's a jack.
Okay, I will keep that card, and I will say the next card is lower.
You're going to keep it anyway, Sue Ann. You can't change it. Don't get nervous. Lower than a jack.
Lower.
It's an ace! Big break for Bill as Sue Ann loses both of those cards, and we look at this base card, Bill. Five, you cannot change it. You've got to play it. Call this.
Higher.
Higher. Higher than a five. It is a six, just a little bit higher.
Yeah, I want to go on, and I'm going to call the next card a lot higher than that six.
A lot higher. Higher than a six. It's a five, and you lose two cards. Janice, fill in the spaces. Boy, the cards falling funny for the players. As we go to a question to you, Sue Ann.
Okay.
We polled 100 men in the small Idaho town of Craigmont and asked them, do you own a gun in Idaho? How many of those men own guns?
I would think that a lot of them do because they use it for hunting. I say 73 own guns.
73. Bill, higher or lower than 73?
People in those small farm towns probably have guns. I'd say it's higher than that.
Higher than 73. That's a surprise. I'll find out as you do.
I hope it is.
The actual number of men who said they own a gun is 97.
All right.
Very much higher. Bill. Wow. Well, we told you it was in Idaho, and Bill, now we're looking at a five. Are we going to keep it?
I'm going to keep the five and say the next card is higher.
Higher than a five. It's a four. It's not higher. Sue Ann, you cannot change that queen. Call this card.
Lower.
Lower than a queen. It's a jack.
I'll continue to play lower.
Lower than a jack? It's a 10. One right down the line.
I will freeze.
You'll freeze it right there.
I'll freeze.
And that 10 becomes a new base card. Janice will fill in the space for Bill, and we'll go to the next question, and it goes to you, Bill. We asked 100 women senior citizens, do you still have your wedding dress? How many of them said yes?
That's something that women hang on to all their lives, I've always thought. I'd say about 70 of them still
70.
Have.
Sue Ann, higher or lower?
I'd say that it's much lower.
You say lower. The actual number of senior citizens who said they still have their wedding dress is 11. Very much lower. Sue Ann, it's you. Want to play this 10 or change it?
I will change it.
And here's the next card, Sue Ann. You have to play this one. It is a 2. Call this
I will say the next card is higher.
Higher than a two. It's a seven.
I will freeze.
You'll freeze it right there. She needs just one card to win. Bill needs all four of them. And with Sue Ann leading 1-0 in the match, we're going to take time out for a commercial message. Don't you go away. Well, we're running out of time. Sue Ann, I've got to ask you there. You froze on that seven, needing just one card to win. Did you know the next question coming up was sudden death?
Yes.
Yes, so that puts the pressure on Bill, no matter how it comes out. And of course, our friends at home know that with a sudden death, someone's got to win with that next play of the cards. Bill,
that's right.
Going to make a comeback?
I sure am.
Well, we'll find out. Sue Ann, you need just one more to get another crack in the money cards. Bill trying to dethrone her. Hope you'll join us next time to find out how it all comes out. We're starting with sudden death next time on Cards Right. Bye-bye.
Some of our contestants will receive Bissell's 2-in-1 formula. Carpet shampoo and soil guard keeps carpets cleaner, brighter, longer. And an electrofoam shampooer. Save time and work with Bissell. And for international entertaining or everyday meals, West Bend's Electric Oriental Wok. It's ideal for stir frying, simmering, and stewing. And through test, Easy Care Latex Flat Enamel combines the flat finish of latex with the scrubability of enamel. Exclusively from True Value Hardware Stores. And Smooth and Silky by Remington. The electric razor for women that we believe shaves as well as a blade, the Remington Smooth and Silky. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.